Tired of a chaotic device list? Tired of too many flows just to keep the lights on? Or just curious if you know enough about zones? Let me show you zones. In this video, I'll go through what zones are and how to use them. Zones are a way to group devices within your home. Think of it as rooms and areas. At my home, I've grouped every part of my house in different zones as shown here. There is always a zone in the top, which usually is called home, but you can rename this to your liking. Under home, you can add multiple zones, and you can even add zones within zones. I've divided my home into four main zones: inside, outside, apartment, and garage. Inside the garage, there is only one room, so I have no child zones there. For the apartment, I really have not a lot of smart things, so this is not in use either. Outside, I've added all the lights on the outside of my house, and lastly, inside is divided up into two floors, basement and first floor. In these two zones, I've divided up all the rooms and hallways. The main reason I've done this is so I can use some of the zone blocks the Homey has, which I'll go through soon. But first, let me show you how to create and manage zones. Go to my.homey.app and select devices on the left side. On the bottom, you'll see the new zone button. Press this and enter the name for the zone you want to add. I'll add a fictional third floor. I can now right-click or select the three dots on this zone to rename, change the icon, move, or delete it. Let me change the icon to the roof of a house and move it into the inside zone. As you see, I now have the third floor zone as a child of the parent inside zone. So to add multiple zones, just rinse and repeat. To move devices, you can either drag and drop them into the correct zone or right-click and move them to a zone. Important to note: devices in a zone will also be in the parent zone. So if a device, for example a smoke sensor in my third floor zone, goes off, it will also be detected by blocks from the inside zone and the home zone. This will be easier to understand once we talk about the flow blocks for the zones. Speaking of flow blocks, let us see them. I am using the advanced flow to show a simple overview over the available blocks. If you have not seen advanced flow before, please click the in video link or see in the description. Let's start with the home zone. This zone has a few special blocks which none of the user created zones have. I'll go through the unique blocks of the home zone first, and we'll go through the other blocks once we go through the blocks available for the user created zones. First off, we have the block labeled alarm type turned on. Alarm type can be any of the alarms shown here. This can be used to trigger if a smoke alarm starts beeping or motion alarm. This will be triggered by any devices you have in this zone or any child zones of this zone, as I mentioned before. So a quick flow example would be to notify you once a smoke alarm went off. The name and zone of the device is also passed along using tags, so if you send a notification, you can pass these values as well within the notification. This will be true with most of the blocks. Just hover the mouse over the tag icon and you'll see what is passed along with a small example text. The second block is just opposite of the previous. It just triggers whenever the alarm selected turns off. The third block is triggered once a device has their value changed. This value can be any of the values shown here. An example is when any temperature sensor drops below a given value, you can add a notification to check out why. The fourth block is if a device has not been reported by a given duration. Usually wireless devices report every 24 hours or whenever they get triggered. So if a device has not reported within 24 hours, this can mean the device has drained its batteries. Under, and the then blocks are the same as on the user created zones. So let's scroll down to the blocks available for our third floor zone we created. As you see under the when blocks, there are four different blocks. These are all triggered based on activity in this zone or a child zone. To quickly explain all four, they are triggered whenever any motion or contact sensor goes off. So if there is a motion and door sensor inside of this zone and I move or open the door, the top block will go off instantly. The second block will only be triggered once the activity has been going on for a set amount of time repeatedly. So if you stop moving or the door closes before the set time of this block, it will no longer trigger. An example here will be a door sensor that is triggered when you enter the zone. If you do not close the door within 15 minutes, it will go off. But once you close it, it is no longer an active zone. But keep in mind, if you have movement sensors and you move, the zone is active again. The second two are just the opposite of the first two. And blocks are mostly self-describing. This first one just checks if the zone is active. The second and third can check if any alarm types in this zone are turned off or on. For example, a smoke alarm or motion alarm. The last two actually are used to check if all devices of one type are turned on or off. This can be useful to check if all lights outside are off. Or all lights inside when you leave the house. The then blocks are used to turn on or off all devices of a set type. The types available are the same for the last two blocks we looked at. This is useful if you want to turn on all lights outside after sunset. Or you have multiple lights in a zone you want to turn on when a zone becomes active. I'll show some examples of practical uses for these blocks, which I use all the time. The first and most used is to control light in a room. I have some rooms with multiple sensors and lights. With the old kind of flow, I started doing it like this. One flow for each sensor activates all the lights. Then I needed three flows for when movement stopped. This quickly became a lot to automate. A minimum of six flows was required to make this. Adding delays so light did not turn off as fast if you stand still for too long would add even more flows. So six plus flows. But, using zones, I can get this down to two of the standard flows. Just like this, the first one here turns on all the lights once any motion or contact sensor is activated. And if we look at the second one here, we can see that it will turn off all the lights in that zone whenever it has been inactive for a set amount of minutes. This makes it so much easier to keep the flows clean. If you add a new light in this zone, it will automatically be in this flow. If you add another motion sensor to the zone, it will also trigger this flow without modifications. Let's go back to advanced flows, which will be a game changer to keep things tidy. Let me recreate the same two flows using our third floor zone to turn lights on and off based on activity in the zone. Do you see how simple and clean this is to control lights and motion in zones? Using advanced flows, you could add this for every zone in one flow. Let's create another quick one in this same advanced flow. Let me add the sunset and sunrise block. And add the turn on and off blocks from the outside zone. So let's connect up. At sunset. Turn on. All lights. At sunrise. Turn off. All lights. Now this simple flow actually turns the lights on or off based on the sunset and sunrise. Now we will create another flow. Let's now use the home zone block, a sensor type value changed. And since I have a lot of battery devices, I personally use this flow. Let's set the sensor type to battery, and now add a logic function, value is less than. Let the value be the value tag from the trigger block and less than 10. This will run only when a battery changes and it is below 10%. Now let's create a timeline notification. Battery on device and insert tag name. Is at and insert tag value. This is located in zone, insert tag zone. Now every time a battery-powered device reports a lower value than 10%, I will be notified and be running to swap with one of my recharged batteries. Well, hope you learned something new, and if there are any questions, please feel free to ask down in the comment section. And I hope you have a great day.